Good afternoon. I'm Willie Bowen. I'm the editorial director at Farm Progress. You may know us for our farm show, but in addition to that, we have 22 state and regional magazines and vertical publications, including Delta Farm Press, Ohio Farmer, Indiana Prairie Farmer, plus Beef, National Hog Farm. We're kind of busy in the media business. And I'm excited to be here. I cover technology for our magazines, as well as work with our team. Today, you're going to be excited. I was able to drag these guys off the show floor, wherever they were, for an hour to spend with you, to talk about in-season fertilizer and nutrient application, which is becoming a bigger and bigger deal. Fall is less fun for putting stuff down when it comes to EPA and your crop. Our final speaker is Shawn Gerdeman from Unverferth. I'm going to turn it over to you. I think I have your first slide up, so that'll be better for you.
Thank you, Willie. Thanks for the intro. Thanks for everyone's attendance today. My name is Shawn Gerdeman, Unverferth Manufacturing. We're an agricultural manufacturer based out of Northwest Ohio. We've been in the business for over 60 years. We're proud to show you our NutriMax liquid applicator. This is year number three of our production. We're seeing a trend of getting the nitrogen into the soil. Into the soil several inches so that we don't lose it. Studies upon studies, and I'm sure you've heard them all, is get the nitrogen on as close to the crop, as close to the cropping season growing as possible. And on our lot, we do have a NutriMax. It's a liquid nitrogen applicator. It's a 60-foot toolbar. It's on tracks. It's 2,600 gallon, and we are proud to be a 4R nutrient stewardship member. What that means is getting the nutrient, the right source of nutrient, the right rate, the right time, and very important, the right place. We are all aware there's different methods that we can put nitrogen on. Dry, granular urea, gas, vapor, such as anhydrous ammonia, that is very popular. And liquid, nitrogen, such as 28%, 32%. We're seeing a trend across the corn belt to use liquid. It's a method of getting the nitrogen right into the row, into the soil, where it cannot volatilize and be used in a timely manner, right next to plant roots. Again, you can see the coulter right between the corn rows. But again, there are different methods of doing it. You can broadcast, put the urea down in front of the corn planter and work it in. But our system, which we've seen growers throughout the Midwest, a lot of our customers that build grain handling equipment, tillage equipment, they look to our products and look at our nitrogen applicator and some of the features that I'll go over with you, and very happy with the results that they're seeing. A pound of nitrogen usually equates to a bushel of corn. So if our yield goal is 200 bushel, we're usually going to shoot for about 200 pounds. Now, pushing the envelope of yield, 200 bushel seems to be in the past, and we're focus on 300 now. And the good news is, if you get the fertilizer down at the right time in the right place, we don't need 1 pound of nitrogen for 1 bushel. We get it down the right spot at the right time, we can get that 300. We can get it higher than that. And that's the key. That's the key to the yields, increasing our yields, getting it in the right spot, the right time, so when the plant can use it. There's a chart that you can see here. I'm sure you've seen this before. When is the best time to apply it? Now, nitrogen is not immediately available because the microbes in the soil need to turn it into a usable product for the corn. So you can see the chart, B12, the corn is starting to really speed up. B18, it's going into high gear. You can see as it's going into the reproductive stage, where the nitrogen is really being pulled into the plant the right time. The worst thing you want to do is not have the nitrogen available for the plant when it's starting to put its ear set in and fill the kernels completely out. Multiple different ways, as we discussed before, the NutriMax applicator, we have in three sizes, 1400, 1800, 2600 gallon. We make up to a 90-foot toolbar. And this recent year, we came out with a 1440-foot toolbar that also cools down to 30 gallon. Anhydrous is also a method of using dry fertilizer and strip-till application, and dry fertilizer and broadcast application. And some of the punchline to this chart, if you can see, we've got the tractor horsepower required, the mile per hour you can travel, the rate per acre you can do, and acres per hour, and acres per fill. Now, as you go down the chart, you can see your acres go up because you don't need as much horsepower, you know, in a broadcast situation. And then in a strip till, it's getting into the soil, however, it takes a lot of horsepower. Anhydrous, also, you need to get the shank in the ground to seal the product so you don't lose it. Now, on top of a liquid applicator, we can go faster speeds and get more done per day. One of the customers that we talked to, you know, anhydrous is very widely used, and it's a cheap form to put nitrogen on. However, horsepower, you need to hold that shank fairly deep. Several highlighting features of our NutriMax, maximizing fertilizer value, and a high level feature also, how this thing folds. You can see how the toolbar is very compact, the wings fold to the rear. So it's
comment.
wings do flex when we get 15 degrees above and 10 degrees below horizontal. When you pick up the unit on the ends, the wings do tilt up. It prevents crop damage. And it's tied into the hydraulic outlet of the lift, so you don't need to operate another remote. It's very user-friendly. Mentioned before, we make a 90-footer that folds down to 60. We make a 64-foot unit that folds down to 40. We make a 40, a single toolbar, and we make a 48 that folds down to 30. We can tailor 20, 22, and 30-inch row spacings. Talking about our culver, we have a nozzle. And with our nozzle, we have a protector plate. And a lot of guys that have rocks use nozzles. And one of the things we found is having that protector plate prevents the nozzle from getting plugged or damaged by rocks. We have 6-volt hubs, and this is a cousin. This culver is a cousin from our deep till gentleness that we built for over 20 years. If you're familiar with our zone builder, it's an inline ripper that we've built for many, many years. Very similar design, very durable. It's a square post. It won't bend. And new for 2018, double-coulters, we have the ability to split ply between every row. We get 33% closer to the plant roots. So we're taking the same rate, dividing it into two, and getting it 5 inches closer to each row. A lot of interest in this, because as you hear, and as we hear more, getting the nutrient closer to the plant, studies have shown your roots touch less than 1% of soil. So how can we get the nutrients to the plant? Common sense is, let's get it closer.
Again, we do have
depth of each corner so we don't get it too deep and don't get it too shallow. Our tank design, we've been in the sprayer business for 15 plus years, and one of the things that we learned in sprayers is how to drain the product completely out. One of the things we've done is we call it containment tank, which is a sump within a sump. So we have, in essence, have two sumps. So the last 30 gallon gets into the, what I call the primary sump. Then the secondary sump is in the bottom of that. So as you're finishing the field, going up and down hills, terrain, it stays in the sump and can completely drain out. Our quick fills in the rear, a lot of guys like to leave the toolbar folded out back up to the nurse trailer. Fill right in the back. We've got a washing container in the back to keep your hands up. We've also got a, it tells you how full the tank is on the front and rear of the tank. We have hydraulically driven pumps, and we call them PWM, pulse width modulated. And the benefit of that is, as you operate your equipment, you don't always sit there with your engine wide open. You always use your tractor engine, your combine engine, as you need it, so you don't use too much fuel and wear out your equipment. PWM is the same philosophy. The pump speeds up and slows down as your rig changes. So as you slow up and slow down and speed up with your applicator, the pump changes its velocity, changes its output, so it preserves the life of the pump, and it's a better overall system. It doesn't overuse hydraulics that your tractor's putting on. We have a run drag pump option. Centrifugal pumps over the years, you need to have fluid in them. We do have a run drag pump, which means that the tank is empty, and you leave it on, the seal will not go up. Low back ball valves. What those mean, when you shut the toolbar off, when you shut your rose off, when you turn on the headlamps, a lot of times you see the liquid product dripping out because the pressure in the toolbar is draining. What we have are flow back valves, which means when the valve shuts, we've got a pressure relief. So the pressure in lines returns back to the tank. Very successful item for sprayers. So headlands, turning, waterways, when you turn the toolbar off, turn the rig tool off, blu-jet's off, fuel washer's off as well. Our undercarriages, as I mentioned, we have a track unit on our lot. We call it the equalizer track. It rotates both fore and aft and side to side. We have duals. We are also a wheel company where we manufacture agricultural wheels. It's one thing we've done for many, many years. And so we love wheels and we can do various row spacings and various things. So if you need custom built wheels for any of your equipment, we are your source as well. You can see in this picture about our equalizer track. What's unique about this, you see the front idler wheel, the front bear wheel, and then the front little bogey wheel. Those two are tied together. Okay? And then on the back end, the little wheel in the back and then the larger wheel, those are also tied together. So it walks within itself. So as you go in and out of fields, we don't have a point load on any particular wheel or any particular hub. It equalizes out. Standard Raven built 450 controller in it. in essence, it's paint uplifted carrier, and the paint gets bonded to the steel at high temperature. It's very durable. We are very narrow on our transport window. As you can see in this picture, on a conventional road, we're staying within that 115 feet and under 13 feet tall. And that is a 60-foot diameter. Talk about micronutrients a little bit. One of the neat things about liquid fertilizer is you can put other things in it. You know, with gas, such as the anhydrous, it's a single product you're putting on at that time. So the neat thing about 28 and 32, you can tank mix micronutrients in, which I personally, in the last year, added sulfur to my 28 mix. And sulfur is one of the low-hanging fruit of nutrient. It's inexpensive, but like nitrogen, it leaves the soil. So one thing to keep in mind is the ability to add micronutrients such as sulfur. And again, sulfur is not very expensive, and it is a field crop if you don't have it. So that's a neat thing, and a new item that growers are learning is what micronutrients does my crop not have, because as we all know, you can't get maximum yield if one of the building factors nutrients isn't there. So that is the ability to add that. You can put stabilizers in with this inductor. And what's neat about this inductor as well is it's a pressure side inductor, which means when you put the product in, it blows the product right into the tank. It doesn't very abrasive product in, and pull it right from this inductor through the pump, it's going to wear it out. So it does, it's a pressure side, which means it pushes the product into the tank, and then dilutes it, then it pulls back from the pump to blend it into your tank. It's very easy to use for all. Well, it's a great day in Kentucky. We appreciate your time. The good news is we're seeing the commodity prices go in the right direction. And with that, one of the things we know is commodities are lower than what they were in the past, but we keep our yields up and improve our bottom lines as well. So thank you for your time. Stop by our lot. We'd love to show you the new products we have, such as the dual delivery, the applicator, and get that nitrogen right where you need it. Thank you. Micronutrients.